Hello students, we were studying the chapter Bholi in which we saw how the teacher of Bholi encouraged her to read and write and become literate. Later we came to know that the parents forced her or compelled her to marry Bishambhar Nath, who was of the same age of her father. During the marriage we see that when the wheel of the bride or Bholi slips back, Bishambhar takes a glance and his garland is poised or still motionless, becomes motionless in his hands when he sees the pock marks on her face. And this is what he shares with his friend. But the reaction which came from the friend was that you are also not a young groom. You are also a very elderly person. So if the girl has adjusted, you should also adjust. But Bishambhar Nath asked 5,000 rupees in the form of dowry to marry Bholi. Ramlal went and placed his turban, his honor. You know that if you have seen Indian movies, the turban represents the honor of a person. So he kept the turban just in his feet, at his feet, at Bishambhar's feet. Do not humiliate me so. So please don't humiliate me before all these people. Let me remain a respectful person. And please marry my daughter. Take 2,000 rupees. 5,000 rupees is a very huge amount. No, 5,000. Or we go back. Keep your daughter. But he is also very insensitive here. And he says that if you don't give me 5,000 rupees, you keep your daughter and we will take we will go back with all our family members and the procession. Be a little considerate, please. If you go back, I can never show my face in the village. You know, these are Indian customs and Indian traditions and Indian mindsets that if a barat or a procession goes back without marriage, then this would bring a lot of defame and disgrace to the family, especially to the bridal family, bride's family. So he pleads. Ramlal is pleading before Bishambhar Nath. Be a little considerate. And he says that I will not be even able to show my face to anybody in the village. Then out with 5,000. But Ramlal was, or Bishambhar Nath here, was adamant and he said that I just want 5,000 rupees. Tears streaming down his face. But this was a huge amount. Ramlal went in, opened the safe and counted out the notes. He placed the bundle at the bridegroom's feet. He brought the money because he was also a prosperous farmer. Maybe he is able to make the money. He brought the bundle and he kept at the bridegroom's feet because with a lot of respect he gave or he fulfilled the demand which was made by Bishambhar Nath. On Bishambhar's beady face appeared a triumphant smile, a winning smile that I have won. He had gambled and won. This was not less than a gamble. Gamble means jua. So this was like a gamble. And he won. He got the 5,000 rupees. Give me the garland, he announced. And now he again is ready to marry. He is taking the garland. But you remember, now he has agreed to get married because of money. Once again, the wheel was slipped back from the bride's face. But this time, her eyes were not downcast. The girl, Bholi, was not looking down. Here, She was just looking at him. She was looking up, looking straight at her prospective husband. And she was just looking at the to-be husband of hers towards Bisham Bernard's face. And in her eyes, there was neither anger nor hate, but only contempt. So she was not angry, and nor is she hating him, but she is looking at him with contempt. She dislikes the last gesture, the last action of this man. Bishamber raised the garland to place it round the bride's neck, as is done to marry somebody. But before he could do so, Bholi's hand stuck out like a streak of lightning, and the garland was flung into the fire. Bholi threw this garland into the fire. She got up and threw away the wheel. Even the wheel or the ghungat was also thrown away by her. That means she has openly shown that she is not ready to marry Bishamber. Pitaji, said Bholi in a clear, loud voice. And her father, mother, sisters, brothers, relatives and neighbors were all startled and surprised and shocked to hear her speak without even the slightest stammer. They were not even knowing that now she doesn't stammer. She is a literate girl. She is a confident girl. She doesn't stammer. Pitaji, take back your money. I'm not going to marry this man. So what is her decision? She's smart enough to take her own decisions also. She has decided she is not going to marry Bishamber Nath. And she rejects thus the whole procession along with the bride and his family would be sent back. This would only bring dishonor to the bridegroom's family because the bride has rejected to marry now. Bholi doesn't want to marry Bishamber Nath at all because of his greediness. Okay, let us see what she says. Ram Lal was thunderstruck. He was just shocked. The guest began to whisper, so shameless, so ugly and so shameless. So everybody is criticizing Bholi that she's ugly. And then also she's moreover shameless on the top of it. Bholi, are you crazy? Shouted Ram Lal. Even the father shouted at her. You want to disgrace your family? Have some regard for your Izzat. So Izzat is something we all Indians worry a lot. For the sake of your Izzat, said Bholi, I was willing to marry this lame old man. He is lame. He is physically challenged. But only for your Izzat, father, I was ready to marry. But I will not have such a mean, greedy, and contemptible coward as my husband. But after looking at him and his mentality, his actions, I have decided that I will not marry this man because he is mean, he is greedy, and he is contemptible. Coward. He's a coward also. Woderpok hai, contemptible. A person worthy to be criticized. He's not good as a husband. How can he be my husband? I will not marry him. What a shameless girl. We all thought she was harmless, dumb cow. This is what all the Indian boys think when they marry, that the girls should be harmless, dumb cow. They shouldn't have their opinion. They should not be saying anything. They should just be following orders. Bholi turned violently on the old woman. When this lady said this, she also here spoke out. What did she say? Yes, auntie, you are right. You all thought I am a dumb, driven cow, but I am not. That's why you wanted to hand me over this heartless creature. So this man, Bishamber Nath, has been referred to as a heartless creature, a heartless animal. And you feel that I am a dumb cow. But now the dumb cow, the stammering fool, whom you called a stammering fool, the girl who stammered and is a fool, is speaking. Do you want to hear more? I can even speak more. Bishamber Nath, the grocer, started to go back with his party. He understood that this girl is not so dumb and so unwitty. She is intelligent enough to think and speak. So he started to go back. The confused bandsmen thought this was the end of the ceremony and struck up a closing song. We know that whenever the marriage ends, it is all a bidai song that is played. So the band started playing the closing song, or we can say bidai song, that they are going back. Ramlal stood rooted to the ground. He didn't know what to do. His head is bowing low with the weight of grief and shame. He is sad also, and he is ashamed also, because the marriage has not worked properly. They are not able to marry each other. Okay. The flames of the sacred fire slowly died down. Even the flames which were there for the seven pheras had slowly died. Everyone was gone. Ramlal turned to Bholi and said, "But what about you? No one will ever marry you now. What shall we do with you?" The father is now speaking to the daughter, that what will you do in your life now? No one will marry you. And Sulekha said in a voice, now what is, instead of Bholi, what is written? Sulekha. Because she has her own identity very good enough. She said in a calm and steady voice, "Don't you worry, Pitaji. In your old age, I will serve you and mother, and I will teach in the same school where I learned so much. Isn't that right, ma'am?" And she's asking her teacher also. So such a great work. She sacrificed her own life for taking care of her parents. Can you imagine? The same girl who was ignored and was not paid attention to has now sacrificed her life for the parents. The teacher had all along stood in a corner watching the drama that was going on. "Yes, Bholi, of course," she replied. And in her smiling eyes was the light of a deep satisfaction that a teacher has when a student of his or her does very well in their life. So there's a deep satisfaction in the teacher that an artist feels when contemplating the completion of her masterpiece. And what is this satisfaction compared to? An artist who feels the maximum satisfaction when he has drawn the masterpiece of his, made the masterpiece, then the artist feels the maximum satisfaction and happiness. Similarly, the teacher has felt the happiness and satisfaction today when she saw Bholi having such a great ideas in her life and sacrificing for her parents. So she was extremely happy and supported Bholi. I hope, students, you would have understood this chapter written by K.A. Abbas. Try to understand it and read the whole chapter thoroughly.